Would you describe yourself as a super mum?
I don't like that expression. I don't feel super a lot of the time. In fact, my husband's always joking as I drag baskets of laundry across the floor that he'll take a photo and put it on Twitter. So this is the real life. I think there are definitely things I'm proud of, and there's definitely, I feel very, very lucky, if that doesn't sound too smug, to be a mother of 9 really wonderful children. But it is quite a logistical struggle sometimes, and they are normal children with lots of ups and downs in daily life.
What took you on this massive journey to become not just a mother of 9 people, but as I was saying, also the head of a major company?
I didn't have a grand plan, didn't have this great set of ambitions on either having a large family, although we wanted 5, so I suppose that does count as a large family, but also becoming the CEO. What I did do though was take opportunities as they arose.
Your husband does a lot of the taking care of the children. How important is that partnership for you?
Well, I've sometimes been accused of saying you can only do what I've done if you have a house husband. That's not what I say. I think if you've got 9 children, it is very difficult to imagine how you would have a life as a family if both parents were having, high-powered jobs. But my husband did work until we had our 4th child. He was a financial journalist. And we had what was, I thought, quite a normal conversation as a partnership, how will we make it work? And he volunteered to go freelance. But it obviously now our lives have got to the point he doesn't work for money anymore.
You've mentioned in the past about how when you had your first baby, age 25, unplanned. When you went back to work, you were passed over for promotion and you asked your boss at the time, who was a man, why? And he said, it's obvious, you've had a baby. Now, that might have been an acceptable attitude all those years ago, but it isn't today. How can your example change that?
One of my lessons always is that it's not that easy. And success, people think of successful people as having a gliding through life and everything going perfectly. With success comes failure as well. Almost every day there's a setback and there's it's one step forward, a half a step back type of thing. So I try to encourage women to be resilient and to accept that actually when you have a child, obviously your life changes dramatically, but it doesn't change exactly the same way forever. And also, that you could perhaps work differently rather than just down tools. It's not a binary outcome.
Well, how exactly do you balance the competing needs of your children and also your job?
So this is one of the wonders of the modern age, because as I've grown older and had more children, so has technology advanced hugely. And it definitely is a huge part of how I work, that I can go in and out of work and home. And for me, that's the secret. I mean, I'm hoping that the whole gender discussion and the spotlight on women at work actually challenges companies to rethink their working practices. Technology isn't being used enough to really allow people to work better and smarter. I want companies to start measuring output, not input, not hours at the desk. And that's really the goal. But that would change work for everybody, not just women.